Let me in. Let me in. March 17th, day 5, St. Patrick's Day. When I was out my way here, I didn't really expect people to start kind of going until, you know, probably like afternoon. Everyone was green, bars were already starting to pop. Trying to get some footage on my way back, but this is my first St. Patrick's Day in Huntington Beach. Apparently they know how to celebrate it pretty well. I don't have any green on me, I have my green backpack, but Madison's family's gonna be here in about 2 hours, so try to get some good surfing in. It's calm and small. 2 days ago when I went last, I was very disappointed because I talked about how good it was gonna be and then proceeded to just nose plant once in 2 hours and then call it a day. So I'm feeling good for today. A lot of people out, but so I ride my electric longboard out here. Is it right here? Great that I can have like both my free hands, and I just love longboarding, but when I get here, I have to leave my longboard in my backpack, like on the beach. And now that I'm starting to film, I have a lot of valuable in my bag. I probably shouldn't be saying this, but I leave all my valuables just on the beach. I'm just like always sketched out. I just don't know how to do it a better way. All right, enough dilly-dallying. It looks really good.
Tell you what, I still really need to improve my paddling out. When I'm alone, I have a bad habit of throwing my board, which I know you shouldn't do, but when there's no one around like a 100-yard radius to me, I feel pretty comfortable doing it, but it's a bad habit. Shouldn't be doing it. Yep, that would have been bad.
I hope that thumbnail was worth it. I got a bunch of sand in this thing. Filming yourself surfing is pretty damn easy. It's just essentially get this, you don't need this little floaty device, but it just alleviates a peace of mind. If you do drop the GoPro, it'll actually float instead of just sink immediately to the bottom. And then what you do is you just get this little mouth guard I found on Amazon. I'll put everything I have in the description. It was super cheap. The whole setup I have, not including the GoPro, is probably like 30 bucks or something. Hold it in your mouth and then just kind of record whenever. The hardest part is like hitting record and then missing a wave and then not hitting record and then going back, and all you can see is just like blue water as footage. So it's good to have like a system. Every time I like record and I get like a wave, or maybe I get like a shot that I think was good, or maybe it wasn't like worth it, at the end of it, I'll put a thumbs up or thumbs down. So I'm editing, I can just go to the end. If I see a thumbs up, it's a video I'm gonna wanna use and like see what it was about. Or if I see a thumbs down, it's something I just kind of ignore and move on. So it beats sifting through like an hour of just me like looking at the water. And it took a minute to figure out, cause that's what I first started doing. And I was like, this takes too damn long. But no, it's a great setup. And then I also have, I don't use it very often, but I would like to, probably with like boogie boarding. Basically it's just like you keep this orange thing on and I have a little handle and it straps around my wrist, and it's really easy. Madison got me a GoPro for Christmas and I've really been liking using it.
Hi.
I got eaten by a shark. I love you. Any news from your fam?
I probably got like about an hour left. I want to keep surfing until I gotta head back home. So I'm gonna put the GoPro down and see if I can get some good shit. The GoPro it's great, but like your mouth is always like open to the water, so you're just like constantly are just like swishing around seawater. It works really well and I can breathe, but it's
Am I late?
Yes.
What the? I'm never late.